Hi everyone. So this is the first video for PU2, I think. So already we have completed the topic called solid state. So in that regard, what I thought is it will be best opportunity for you people to revise once again. And even certainly the student who are newcomer, they were asking about to revise that topic. So that's why I took this topic for these 10 to 15 days online classes. So in these 10 to 15 days classes, we will try to complete the solid state. For those who have already attended these solid state, for them it will be like a revision, and for those who are newcomers in our college, for them it will be like fresh class, right? So the name of that topic will be the solid state, right? So and this topic carries 7 to 8 marks, right? Nearly plus or minus 1 marks, we can say. So here, first of all, if we see the first year chemistry. So in first year, we already came across these two gases and liquids, right? In case of states of matter chapter, if you remember. So in case of states of matter, we have already studied about the gases and the liquids. So before directly moving into the solid state, so let me introduce what is the solid state. What is the internal arrangement of solid state, how the constituent particles are present in the solid state. So like we will see with the comparison. Let us consider a matter. So any matter, if it is a solid, then its arrangement always will be like this, right? So the particles are just like a overlapping. That means the small atoms which are involved in the formation of this matter, if it is a solid type, then definitely there will be a no gap between any two constituent particles. If I consider these two as a constituent particle of solid state, then definitely there will be a no gap. There is no gap in between any two constituent particles. That means they are very closely arranged. Since they are not having a space in between them, they cannot move freely, right? Which is very important. So now that means if they are very close, with no space in between them, then definitely it will be very difficult for them to move easily, as we see in case of liquid and gases, right? So if you can consider this as a gas and this will be a liquid, right? So that's why there is no movement between any two constituent particle present in the solid. Due to that, they cannot move. If you want to move that particular matter of solid, then we have to put some amount of energy, right? A manpower, we can say, right? We have to put some amount of energy. That means external energy. They cannot move because of this. That means in solid, the in between any two constituent particles or any two atoms, there is no freedom. There is no gap. Due to this, what happens is they cannot move freely. If they are not moving freely in the matter, then definitely that matter will not displace itself. To displace it, what we need to do? We have to apply some amount of energy. It may be a electrical energy or whatever it may be, right? So this is the general structure of a solid. So in this topic, what we need to do is we need to have a 3D view of solid. We are going to study or we are going to deal the 3D structure of solids. In the solid state, we are going to see in this particular chapter, that is the 3D structure of the solids. That means we can consider any three properties like length, breadth or height, right? So like this, we have, three dimensionally we are going to see the solid state topic, right? So say again, if I say if there is a solid, then if I pass a light, right? Crystallographically, if we study these solids, that means if I pass an X-ray through this solid, then see what we are going to see. We are going to see how the constituent particles are arranged in the solid, whether they are spherically arranged or they are cubically arranged, or they are cone shaped, whatever it may be. What is the internal structure of it, we are going to see now. See here, after passing a light, there is a ZLS screen, right? So ZLS screen is transparent screen. Wherever there is a constituent particle, we will observe the dark spots, right? Like this. In solid, so what we are going to do is what we are trying to see is we are just passing this solid with the X-ray. So X-ray, what it will do is it will pass that solid, and wherever there is a presence of a constituent particle, it will give just a dark spots. And if we connect these dark spots, then they do appear like a cube, like this, right? And they appear like a cube. So it will be a giant like this, right? This is the arrangement. That means in solid, the constituent particles are arranged in cube manner. So to that cube, we have to study like how in 3D format, right? So one, we came to know how the internal structure appears in case of solid. The constituent particles are very systematically arranged in cubic manner, right? So that cube we have to study like in case, in 3D view, right? Like this. If we write this cube, then the cube looks like this, just like a single room, right? So for this, to understand this solid state, we have to consider the cube as a room. So if I consider this as a room, we are sitting somewhere over here, right? Like this. If we assume like that, then this topic will be very easy for you to understand, right? So now see, we came to know that in solids, the structure will be like internally, if we see the solid structure, then it will be like a cube. So now our duty is to see what does this cube is consists of, right? So cube consists of these things, like there are corners, and these are faces, right? So these are the faces, And if there is a cube, then definitely there will be a center. So these are the three parts we're going to see in case of the cube. So before going to different type of cells in the solid state, we should understand what are these, right? So if we consider any cube, then definitely there will be a corner, and then definitely there will be a face, and there should be a center, right? So these three parts are quite common in case of cube. Now if we see the corners, so there are eight corners, see here, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this one, 8 corners. Always the number of corners present in the cube will be 8. And if you see the faces, so left face, right face, up, down, front and back, that means there are 6 faces. You can count over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, front one, and we cannot see 3D exactly on the board, you can see only 2D. So thus, you consider one, this one as a back face, and this one as a front face. So likewise, we can see the 6 faces in cube. And center will be always 1, so we cannot separate, for one cube, we cannot go for two centers. So always, if there is a single cube, then definitely it will be always one center only. So like in cube, we have 3 different types, corner, face, as well as the center. So now, the question arises. What that question means is all these solids are having same this type of cube, or else we might see a different type of cubes in case of solids. Yes, of course, we see different type of cubes. That means for your syllabus, we have 3 type of cells, cubes, we can say. So why? Because see, all these solids are not same, right? Some of the solid can very easily, we can very easily break. For some of the solid, we require some amount of energy, large amount of energy. What is the reason behind it? So based on that, for your syllabus, we have 3 type of cubes. Already we saw what is cube and all. So simple unit cell, there are 3 type of unit cell, you can say. Simple, or this can also be called a primitive unit cell. Number one. Number two, body center, BCC, right? And number three, face center, hexagonal, cubic packed, or cubic closed packed, CCP we can call, right? In exam, they may ask FCC, or else for FCC, they can ask directly HCP, explain about HCP, or else they can call, CCP. So these are the 3 type of cubes one we can see in case of your second year syllabus, right? So always they are always arranged in cubic format, the constituent particles, definitely that is for sure, but these are the 3 different parts one we can see in case of these cubes, right? So let us consider the first one, that is simple or primitive unit cell. So simple unit cell. So what is simple unit cell? And these definitions are very important, right? So simple unit cell is nothing but it is a type of cubic unit cell in which the constituent particle, right? If the constituent particles are only present at the center, corner, only at the corners. So it is a type of cell in which the constituent particles are only present at the corners. If a solid, it is a type of solid in which if the constituent particle is nothing but the particle which is, from which it is made up of, right? So if that solid is only present at the corner, if the constituent particles are present only at the corners, then that type of unit cell is called as simple unit cell. Right, I repeat. So we are going to see the different type of unit cell in solids. So first type of unit cell for your syllabus is the type that is simple or primitive unit cell. In simple or primitive unit cell, the constituent particles are only present at the corners. If the constituent particles are present only at the corners, then those are such type of or this type of unit cell is called as simple unit cell. This is a one type of unit cell. Next one, body centered unit cell. So first one, we came to know what is simple. Simple means only at the corner. If the constituent particles are present not only at the corner, as well as at one atom at exactly at the center, right? So next definition I'm explaining about, right? So if the constituent particles are present corner as well as at one constituent particle exactly at the center of the unit cell, then such type of unit cell are called as BCC, that means body centered unit cell. See, very simply we can define. If the constituent particle are present at corner as well as at the body center, then such unit cells are called as body centered unit cell. One more we left, that is FCC. So your syllabus, there is FCC type of unit cell is also there. So what is FCC now? So if the constituent particles are present at the corner as well as at the faces, center of the faces, right? We already know there are six faces. If the constituent particles are present at the corner plus at the faces, then such unit cells are called as face-centered unit cell, right? So here the definition is like this: corner plus faces. Corner plus faces. If the constituent particles are present at the corner as well as at the faces, then such type of unit cells are called as FCC unit cell. And these definitions are very important to understand the next part of the this chapter, right? So I repeat, simple means the constituent particle, if they are only present at the corners, then those type of unit cells are called as simple unit cell. If the constituent particles are present corner plus body center, I mean corner as well as if they are present at the body center, then definitely that type of cells are called as body centered unit cell. And if the constituent particles are present at the corner as well as at the faces, then such unit cells are called as FCC, HCP or CCP type of unit cells. So these are the three different type of unit cells. Today's class you can say as an introductory class. So you just remember these three type of unit cell you people are going to study in case of during your solid state. So you just remember this. In the next class we will discuss the next further part of this. Okay, thank you.